in July 2017, Donald Trump tweeted a ban on transgender people in the military. This started a string of hate towards this community. As a U.S. Marine responded in Time magazine, my patriotism and service should not have an asterisk attached to it, meaning her sexuality should not impact her serving and defending our country. An estimated 16,000 transgender people are in active duty, so why should we take their jobs? I know I do not want to be in the military, so why take away the people who are voluntarily being there? There's no federal laws prohibiting this discrimination, and trans people have a very hard time finding jobs. Part of our country doesn't have any laws or policies to protect them. Today I'll tell you just about what is going on in our country with the policies towards the transgender community. They suffer discrimination in the military, the workplace, and everywhere in between. These people need our help. They're all people, just like you and me. Without our help, they'll stay in hiding forever and not ever be able to live their lives. Here are some examples of transgender women, Laverne Cox and Jazz Jennings. What makes these people any less of a woman than, say, Taylor Swift or Scarlett Johansson? Both of them grew up knowing that they didn't want to be boys. They grew up wearing dresses, playing with dolls, and took dance classes. So why is that any different than when you or your sister grew up? I want you to think, what if this was your brother? Would you bash them, hate them, and judge them for their views? How would you treat them? Would you bully them? No, you wouldn't. You'd accept them and love them, and I guarantee a lot of you in here would probably beat up anyone who is doing the same to them. There's discrimination everywhere in our world, but I'm mostly focusing on the military and in the workplace. Trump tweeted a ban in July of 2017 without discussing it with his Secretary of Defense, claiming that they were a burden and that they were too expensive to have. Military.com says that the official policy stated, transgender persons who require gender transition surgery are disqualified from military service. Although they claim that it would be too expensive, but in reality, costs would increase no more than 0.04% to 0.13%. And it wouldn't impact any part of military service, meaning having a transgender member in your troop wouldn't have any impact on how the troop works. Forbes magazine says that the military would spend less than a tenth or less than 5% of the overall military budget, health budget, on transgender-related costs. So that means on transition surgeries or hormones. Trump claims that it would be too expensive, but according to health.military, which is the military health website, last year they spent $84 million on Viagra alone. As the American Civil Liberties Union put it, what the White House released, meaning Donald Trump's tweet, was transphobia masqueraded in a policy. There's still no federal laws banning the discrimination based on gender and sexual orientation, according to the Transgender Law Center. There are only 18 states who have laws that strictly prohibit this form of discrimination, including Iowa as one of those states. But there are still 32 remaining states where people can be discriminated based on their sexual identity, according to Ballotpedia.org. More than 1 in 4 transgender people have lost jobs due to bias. 3/4 of them experience workplace discrimination. The National Center for Transgender Equality says that people experience the refusal to hire based on bias, they experience harassment and other forms of bullying. 1 in 8 transgender people will resort to underground economies, meaning prostitution or drug dealing, just to survive. Half of our country doesn't provide clear protection for these transgender people. Our troops and transgender members of society have been wronged by our country, but there's something that we can do to stop it. How the transgender people in our society have been treated is a major issue in our country, and we need to end the discrimination. The easiest way is if you see something, just say something. It is that simple. Transphobia is very, very real, and it needs to be stopped. There's multiple websites that you can visit that will send a message to Congress on your behalf to let your voice be heard. Websites like transequality.org. Without more equality laws in place, people who identify as transgender will struggle for the rest of their lives. Suicide rates are higher in the transgender community, according to an article called Suicide and Suicidal Behavior Among Transgender Persons from the U.S. National Library of Medicine Institute of Health. 32 to 50% of the transgender community will attempt suicide, as compared to only 5% of the general public. According to the Human Rights Campaign, transgender people could be discharged from the military on the basis of being transgendered, and that's it. They've been denied health insurance through TriHealth, which is the military health care provider for transition surgeries and hormones, according to the Washington Post. If transgender people are accepted by all, they'll live happier and healthier lives. Suicide rates could fall as much as 50%, and more people will voluntarily serve in the military. These people will also take part in our community to create a more diverse community. With your help, we can help the transgender community. They're all people, so why should they be treated any differently? Discrimination in the military and in the workplace needs to end. The laws need to be changed, and lives need to be saved. Stand up for transgender rights.